have been having a run of complaints about communication companies. 2degrees a couple of weeks ago, Vodafone last week. So tonight we want to welcome Spark to the party, a telco trifecta.
Yes, at first glance the problems are very different. Being charged for premium text messages, that was 2degrees. Difficulties dealing with death, that was Vodafone. And now a landline that only works part-time.
That is annoying, but the underlying issue in all of these things is the same. It's poor customer service. Here's Garth.
We're in vineyard country, Hawke's Bay, Gimblet Gravels. Vines in row upon row below, ready to grow great New Zealand wines.
So it's hard ground?
It's very hard ground.
Alan Limmer was one of the first planting here.
You've got to be patient to make wine, haven't you?
Yeah, very, very.
You think you've been pretty patient with Spark?
It's wearing out.
Yep, it's the landline, not the grapevine, vexing Alan.
What do you think of Spark's 2019 vintage?
Well, I'm still on 2018.
Getting hold of Alan hasn't been easy. His home phone has been on the blink for nearly 9 months.
You never know when it's actually going to work. And you can be making a call and then suddenly it just chops you off. And other times you just can't call.
No problem. Get it fixed, right?
Well, I've tried the helpline probably 50 times.
50 times?
At least, yeah.
He tried the online chat.
The tech guy gave me the email address in case I needed to get back to him. I did, but he never got back to me.
He went to town.
They have tried in the Spark Centre.
They replaced his hardware twice. Still no service and no follow-up.
Gets to a certain level, like the first level, easy, but it's not fixable at that level, and that's when it dies. And I just wonder if they can't be bothered putting the effort in.
Even when it got to Spark's complex issues team.
It's been escalated a lot of times. I think they've probably run out of floors.
Alan didn't want to pay more for a service that wasn't working.
They offered to send us a technician to come and have a look, but if he couldn't find anything wrong at our end, they were going to bill us for it.
Because it works, sometimes.
Oh, it's ringing. Oh, look.
Hello? Well, I might as well make the most of this phone call.
It's quite a novel experience, isn't it?
It's the only one I've had in about 8 months.
Then, just like Alan said...
Oh. I wonder what happened there.
It's died.
Okay,
well, we've lost the call. It was good while it lasted.
Oh. Look at that. In the middle of the call, that's just cut out, and now you can't ring you.
Well, I was just lucky to get a phone call.
That would be so frustrating.
Even though he's still paying the bill every month...
That just died.
Sometimes you get this.
Welcome to Spark Mobile. The number you've dialed is not currently allocated to a phone. Please check the number and redial.
Well, that's odd.
Alan says there's no pattern.
I'm over it.
And he's been keeping track.
7:30 Monday morning? No. 8:30, yes. 9 o'clock, no. 10:50, no. 11:40, no. 2 o'clock, yes.
What is up? It's not as if a landline is a new thing. We've had working telephone exchanges in New Zealand since 1881.
Mr. Peters calling you from Wellington. Go ahead now, please.
Hello, Alan. How are you?
But they have gone automatic and now digital, wireless, fibre optic, light speed communications. But when it goes wrong, that doesn't guarantee a quick fix.
We dropped the ball, and when I called Mr. Limmer, as soon as the problem was brought to my attention, I apologised for the experience he had. No customer should have to go through that. Thankfully, Fair Go got involved, which meant we remedied the situation in about 3 hours, and that's how long it should take if the correct process is followed.
Why didn't that happen on this occasion?
We have more than 2 million customers, and we have more than 20,000 interactions every single day. We don't get them all right. Sometimes we get them wrong. We are now going through every single interaction that Mr. Limmer had with our team and just making sure that training is in place for each of those individuals because they didn't follow the process. And that's, you know, we've let the customer down and we just apologise for that.
Trust but verify, we say.
Morning.
Hello, Alan.
Garth.
How good is this?
Well, this is amazing. In 24 hours, you guys got my phone working. I could have given birth to a baby in the time it's taken me to get this far with Spark.
But it's sorted, right?
They are checking it regularly now, and they can monitor it from their end. And I have confidence that this fellow that's on the job, he's got it nailed.
You didn't want your money back. Spark says it's making a donation on your behalf to the local hospice in Hastings. $2,000, Alan?
Yeah, that'd be awesome. Good for Cranford. Yeah, great.
All right, job done. I'll let you go.
Thank you. Fair go. Thanks. Okay. Okay, bye.
Thank you, caller.
The landline. So handy. Still got one. Mum rings on it. That is all. Well done, Spark, anyway, for not only sorting the issue, which is good, but also for fronting up and explaining to you guys at home. Like, we didn't even have to ask. They just said, look, get us a camera. We'll be there. We want to talk.
Very refreshing to see such a big company being so proactive.